During 2018, a large section of the Kilauea volcano's summit caldera collapsed in an event which was documented in real time. Over the span of approximately 4 months, not only did the present lava lake drain away, but a slow caldera collapse occurred, with a section of this caldera dropping by as much as 500 meters or 1,640 feet. This caldera collapse did not occur due to a primarily highly explosive eruption like seen at Mount Pinatubo in 1991, but rather mainly due to a large volume effusive flank eruption. This flank eruption began on May 3rd of 2018 as a body of magma slowly intruded into Kilauea's east rift zone before finally erupting 24 and a quarter miles distant at the community of Leilani Estates. As several fissures simultaneously erupted at a rate of more than 100 cubic meters per second, tall lava fountains were generated, one of which during the eruption reached a height of 80 meters or 260 feet. While 23 of these vents would go on to eject large quantities of basalt lava, one vent known as Fissure 17 would instead eject andesite lava in a slightly more explosive fashion compared to the other vents as the intruding magma interacted with an old basalt composition magma body which had been cooling for some time, allowing for it to undergo fractional crystallization since that magma originally was emplaced. By the time the flank eruption had ended 4 months later, a total of 35.5 square kilometers or 13.7 square miles were covered in an estimated 1.4 cubic kilometers of lava. The reason the caldera collapsed was the shallow magma chamber underneath Kilauea's summit was partially drained by a voluminous flank eruption. This caused the ground overlying the chamber to collapse downwards and fill the empty space, widening and deepening Kilauea's summit caldera. While the primarily effusive eruption component-related caldera collapse of the Kilauea volcano in 2018 was a notable recent example of a caldera collapse, other similar events have occurred around the planet during the last century. For example, in Russia from 1975 to 1976, a large effusive eruption occurred at the Tobolchik volcano in the Kamchatka Peninsula, causing a section of its existing caldera to collapse downwards. In fact, these primarily effusive caldera collapse events are surprisingly common in terms of the geologic record, as if you look at the shield volcanoes on various continents, you are likely to see summit calderas caused by this process. While primarily effusive eruption-caused caldera collapse events can last on the order of weeks to months, primarily explosive eruption-caused caldera collapses generally last on the order of hours to days. The reason why primarily explosive eruption-formed calderas form so much faster than large effusive eruption-caused calderas is due to the much greater order of eruptive rate Plinian eruptions have when compared to the vast majority of effusive eruptions. For example, during the largest explosive volcanic eruption of the 20th century, so much volcanic rock was ejected from the newly formed Novarupta volcano that, since the molten rock was being drained from the Katmai volcano's magma chamber, caused the Katmai volcano to collapse into a caldera during the approximately 60-hour-long eruption. While Kilauea's 2018 flank eruption ejected volcanic rock at an average rate of approximately 135 cubic meters per second, Novarupta's 1912 eruption ejected volcanic rock at approximately an average of 144,000 cubic meters per second. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Kylie Raven for becoming a new channel member on YouTube of GeologyHub.